good morning. My name is Kris Bujarski. I am from Lyme, New Hampshire, and I am a behavioral neurologist here at Dartmouth Hitchcock. My clinical expertise is with treatment of several neurological disorders such as epilepsy and dementia such as Alzheimer's disease, which predominantly produce symptoms of memory loss and emotional dysregulation. My specific clinical interest is in the use of a novel technology or an emerging technology called neuro-stimulation to treat these symptoms. Now, what is neuro-stimulation? To put it simply, it is a way of using a device to help control dysfunctional brain regions. Here we have an example. The device is very small and is implanted into the brain of a patient by a specially trained neurosurgeon. The device like this has a computer and goes on the surface of the brain. It also has a sensor that attaches to a dysfunctional area of the brain. The sensor continuously reads the person's EEG and the computer interprets it. When the computer determines that something abnormal is happening, it offers and delivers a pulse, a brief pulse of electricity to fix that area and either make that area function better, increasing its activity or decreasing its activity, depending on the settings. This pulse is imperceptible to the patient, and the patient does not know that the pulse was delivered. The only result is an improvement in their symptoms, such as memory loss. So this technology does sound almost futuristic or science fiction, but in fact, it has been around for quite a while, perhaps 10 or 15 years. It's already has brought symptom relief to many patients suffering from devastating neurological disorders like Parkinson's disease, for instance. Also, it's been used to control seizures in patients with epilepsy. What we are proposing here and what we are trying to do is to use this technology in a very novel way to treat symptoms of memory loss and emotional dysregulation, which are very common in patients with brain injury. My specific area of interest is to treat a part of the brain called the amygdala. Now, the amygdala is a very important brain region. It is involved both in memory and in emotional regulation. In several neurological disorders, such as, for instance, post-traumatic stress disorder, where a patient is plagued by recurrent thoughts and memories of their trauma, the amygdala is dysfunctional, almost overactive. In other patients with traumatic brain injury, for instance, we all hear about how concussed athletes lose control of their emotions. The amygdala also has been implicated in not functioning well. Recently, we did a study here at Dartmouth Hitchcock where we showed patients with an amygdalar stimulation pictures of varying emotional intensity. These patients looked at these pictures either with or without amygdalar stimulation. What turned out in the study was even surprising to us. It turned out that when we stimulated the amygdala, the patients would report that the picture that they're seeing has lower emotional intensity than if we did not stimulate the amygdala. In effect, it brought down the intensity of that picture. What's even more surprising or revolutionary is the fact that 30 minutes after we presented this picture, patients who got the stimulation were less likely to remember specifically the bad or the negative emotional pictures. So in effect, we decreased their ability to remember these negative things. Now, we think that this discovery, which we made here at Dartmouth, has tremendous implications for the use of this technology to stimulate the amygdala and to bring this to patients with a variety of neurological disorders. Now, I don't work here at Dartmouth by myself. I am part of a team which includes a variety of neurologists, neurosurgeons, and psychiatrists, all passionate about this type of technology, and all passionate about bringing it to our patients for treatment. Now, as you can imagine, this research is not easy. It is extremely work intensive, and it is not cheap. We desperately need funding for this research, and I hope that you will be able to help. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Kris. I can absolutely see how this research would have significant impacts and benefits. The question that jumps into mind is, would you see this as potentially having an impact with people who suffer from anxiety, for example, as you're talking about the emotional disruption that comes to mind as a potential benefit?
I think that the full spectrum of applications for this technology is yet to be seen. Mm-hmm. I think anxiety disorders are certainly devastating to certain people, and the brain regions that we are interested in have been implicated in this. Mm-hmm. However, research into things like anxiety has not been done with this. I think this is an excellent potential for future research in this. But I think that this technology has potential wide applications, this being one of them.
Sure. Great. Thank you. Karen?
Thank you. So, Kris, great presentation. I'm curious, though, about what your ultimate goal is for this research. How would you like to see it either expanded to include other institutions and other frameworks across the nation, or are you really looking at just a smaller scope and scale for your project?
Well, this technology at this point is at a very basic level. We are still trying to understand exactly the effects of stimulation on a variety of brain regions and how it changes a person's behavior. And obviously, we want to make sure that there are no adverse effects and that the therapy is effective. So I think at this point, we want to stay focused on small projects that involve very basic questions, such as how does the stimulation affect your memory? How does the stimulation affect your emotions? I think that in the future, bringing this type of stimulation to clinical trials is inevitable and is our goal. I think the clinical trials would start small, but I think the eventual goal would be to bring that to a multi-institutional or nationwide clinical trial.
Wonderful. Thank you so much, and thank you so much, Kris, for your presentation today. It was really helpful.
You're welcome. Thank you very much for listening to me.